what you want to do with it.
Thank you.
Please bow your heads. Most wise and dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for this another day. We thank you for this another season, a season to give thanks, a season to be grateful, a season to be joyful for the birth of Jesus. What a joyous time, what a wonderful time, what a happy time that Jesus is born unto this earth. And thank God for all things. Thank God for all of you. Thank God for Marcia putting this play together. We ask you, please remember us as we're all here. Please remember those that might be trying to get here. Please also remember those that might be in need during this holiday season. Bless us all that we all might remember the reason for this season. Not be distracted by the gifts. Not be distracted by what we're getting, these earthly things, but keeping our mind steadfast on the true gift, the gift of love from God, the gift from Jesus to all of us. And remember us as we're here trying to put on this play. From Sister Marcia, we actually please bless everything to go well. Bless everyone to have a wonderful time. Bless those that are watching that they might enjoy and they might definitely feel the love, feel the work that we put into this. And we ask you, please bless us all. If it be your glorious will, please deliver us all unto tomorrow. Bless us all with safe travels back home. Remember us all in Jesus' name. We pray. Amen. Okay, St. Matthew's first chapter, starting at 17th verse, 18th verse, okay. Now the birth of Jesus Christ was on this wise. When as his mother Mary was espoused to Joseph, before they came together, she was found with child of the Holy Ghost. Then Joseph, her husband, being a just man, not willing to make her a public example, was minded to put her away privately. 20 says, but when he thought on these things, behold, the angel of the Lord appeared unto him in a dream, saying, Joseph, thou son of David, fear not to take thee to take unto thee Mary, thy wife, for that which is conceived in her is of the Holy Ghost. And she shall bring forth a son, and thou shalt call his name Jesus. For he shall save his people from their sins. Now all this was done, that it might be fulfilled, which was spoken of the Lord by the prophet, saying, behold, a virgin shall be with child, and she shall bring forth a son, and they shall call his name Emmanuel, which being interpreted is God with us. Then Joseph, being raised from a sleep, did as the angel of the Lord had bidden him, and took unto him his wife, and knew her not till she had brought forth her firstborn son, and he called his name Jesus. Amen.
In the town of Nazareth in the sixth month, the angel Gabriel appears to a virgin named Mary who was espoused to a man named Joseph.
Hail, thou art highly favored among women. Blessed art thou. Behold, thou shalt conceive and bring forth a son, and thou shalt call his name Jesus. He shall save his people from their sins, and he shall be given the throne of his father David.
Then said Mary,
the Holy Ghost shall come upon thee. That seed that is born of thee shall be called the Son of God. And he shall save his people from their sins. Thy cousin, Elizabeth, she is with seed also. She shall bring forth a son also in old age. In an old age. And with God, nothing shall be impossible.
Behold, the handmaid of the Lord. Be it unto me thy word.
Now Joseph was not left out of this equation. Joseph, when he learned of his espoused wife's condition, being a just man, would not willing to make her a public example, was minded to go put her away privily, but while he thought on these things, behold, the angel of the Lord appeared unto him in a dream, saying,
Joseph, thou son of David, fear not to take unto thee Mary thy wife, for that which is conceived in her is of the Holy Ghost. And thou shalt bring forth a son, and thou shalt call his name Jesus, for he shall save his people from their sins.
And Mary arose and went into the hill country to see her cousin Elizabeth, and when she saluted Elizabeth, the babe leaped in her womb, and Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Ghost. In Bethlehem, Damon the innkeeper is filling his inn.
Silent night, holy night, all is calm, all is bright, round yon virgin, mother and child, holy infant, so tender and mild, sleep in heavenly peace, sleep in heavenly peace.
In Bethlehem, David, the innkeeper, is filling his inn and receiving his money from his many guests. While Joseph and Mary traveled to Bethlehem, nightfall came. The shepherds were watching their sheep when the sky lit up with angels saying, "Fear not, for behold, I bring..."
Thank you.
As Mary and Joseph arrive in Bethlehem, they go to several inns and are turned away as he sees his wife is tired and suffering. Joseph comes and knocks on Raymond's door.
She's calling out from a sea of hurt. Oh, come, oh, come, Emmanuel. And can you hear the angels singing glory? Thank you. heart long for a little bit of hope. Oh, come, Emmanuel.
And on that night, so holy, Christ the Lord was born, for she wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger full with hay. In the morning, the guests have learned of a child being born in the stable. The three wise men arrive from the east and go to see Herod.
King of the Jews? Yes, you must be mistaken. I'm the only king of the Jews. But you go find him and come tell me that I may worship him too.
The shepherds arrive in Bethlehem and find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes and lying in a manger. As the angel had said, they worship him and offer the lamb as a gift. One of the shepherds wanted to play his drum for him.
Thank you.
the wise men arrive at where the stars led them. By now, Mary and Joseph and the baby Jesus are in the house.
We have traveled from the east and were guided by the star. I bring the baby gold.
I too have a gift for the baby. Frankincense.
I, Balthazar, have a gift for the baby as well. The new king, I bring him myrrh.
The kings of Orient are bearing gifts, we drive us afar. Field and fountain, moor and mountain, following yonder star. Oh, star of wonder, star of night, star with royal beauty bright. Westward leading, still proceeding, guide us to thy perfect light.
As was custom, the parents brought the baby Jesus to the temple after he was circumcised on the eighth day to present him to the Lord. Now Simeon, a just and devout man of Jerusalem, was waiting for the consolation of Israel, and the Holy Ghost was upon him. It was revealed that he should not see death until he had seen the Lord Christ. When he saw the parents bringing the baby, he took the child up in his arms and blessed God and said,
servant, depart in peace according to thy will. For mine eyes have seen thy salvation that thou hast prepared us before the eyes of all people, a light to lighten the Gentiles and the glory of thy people Israel.
Anna, a prophetess, the daughter of Phanuel, came in and gave thanks.
Thank you.
sister, a star, dancing in the night with a tail as big as a kite. With a tail as big as a kite. Said the little lamb to the shepherd boy, do you hear what I hear?
Do you hear what I hear?
Ringing through the sky, shepherd boy, do you hear what I hear?
Do you hear what I hear?
A song, high above the trees with a voice as big as the sea. With a voice as big as the sea. Said the shepherd boy to the mighty king, do you know what I know? In your palace warm, mighty king, do you know what I know? A child, shiver in the cold, let us bring him silver and gold. Let us bring him silver and gold. Said the king to the people everywhere, listen to what I say. Pray for peace, people everywhere, listen to what I say. The child, sleeping in the night, he will bring us goodness and light. He will bring us goodness and light.
God bless you. Let's give them a hand. Thank you for attending our play tonight. Now we'll introduce the characters of our Christmas story. Out and step forward when they call your name. Town Crier play and the narrator played by Brother Austin Smith. The Angel Gabriel, played by Brother Anthony Smith. Mary was played by Sister Latoya Smith. Joseph was played by Brother Howard Smith Jr. Elizabeth, who had a child, was pregnant with a child in her old age, played by Sister Tamika, Sister Tamika Smith. The innkeeper, Damon, was played by Brother Matthew Smith. The innkeeper's wife, played by Sister Davina Smith. The innkeeper's daughter, Kadasha, played by Sarah Smith. Corinne, played by Sister Lauren Smith. And Cadell, played by Sister London Smith. Our servant girls tonight, Sister Dorcas was played by Sister Carrigan Smith. And Deidra, who wanted 5 pennies, was played by Sister Brooke Smith. One of our guests, Rhoda, was played by Sister Kezia Smith. And our other guest, Sister Joanna, played by Sister Iris Smith.
Yes.
Our wise men tonight, Melchior, played by Brother Ashton Bell. We had Casper, was played by Brother John David Kirby. And Baltazar was played by Brother Antoine Woodson. And we don't want to leave out our King Herod, was played by Dick and Keith Smith. I hope I didn't miss anyone.
The shepherds.
The shepherds. Okay, where are our shepherds? We have Reuben, Brother Brian
Reuben
Smith Jr. And his brother Asher said, "Don't leave me," played by Brother Bryce Smith. And Simeon, who was waiting for the consolation of Christ, played by Brother Brian Smith Sr. And Anna, the prophetess, the daughter of Phanuel, played by Sister Tara Smith. Is that everyone? Yes, I did, Brother Anthony. Okay. And I am the writer of Mary's Song and the writer of this play, Sister Marcia K. Kirby. Also tonight, I have one of my former piano students, Jonathan Shackelford, to come and play for us today. Thank God for him being willing to come out tonight. I think his parents are here tonight. And Grandma's here tonight, too. Yes. It was Grandma, the one who told me about she wanted her grandson to take piano for me so long ago. I think it was about 12 years ago. So thank God for having you here with us tonight. And all of our guests that are here tonight, Miss Webb, back there. Thank God for her. Sister Alice Smith is here tonight. And Sister Barbara Thomas. I think I see Brother Dominique and Sister Vanessa back there. Mm-hmm. Thank you. Also, Brother Phil is here with us tonight. Thank you, Phil, for coming out. And the sister there, sister, Miss Bird. Glad to have you here tonight. And all our guests tonight. So if I missed anyone, please forgive me, but thank God for you all being here tonight. We ask the pastor to come up and say a few words.
God.
God bless you. On behalf of the Church of God at Williamsburg and the cast, we wanted to present Sister Marcia with a token of appreciation for all that she does to put together this play for us, the writing. We really appreciate it.
Thank you. Glory to God. Thank God.
God bless you all. Give them another round of applause, please. Very wonderfully done. Very wonderfully done. We certainly appreciate Sister Marcia and putting it together and modern day technology, Zoom practice, rehearsals, and in church and whatnot, and put it all together. She wrote it and got it together. So we thank God for bringing the initiative of the birth of Christ and how important it is that through his birth, God brought back into the fold the people of God that God has. We all were born of him. And then through this, we became reconciled back to God, and it's all through the birth of his only begotten Son. So truly, we thank God indeed for Jesus being the reason for this season. And we say Merry Christmas to each and every one of you, and we hope that this play has inspired you to think a little deeper and understanding the reconciliation between God and man. And so truly we thank you. Give them another round of applause. Amen. So we're glad to see each and every one of you that have come out. Are you Shirley? Yes, indeed. Long time, no see. She was a few steps ahead of me in Bruton Heights School. Hey, I'm you and I both. It's good to see you indeed. So this is your grandson? Grandson. Okay, good. All right, great. All right, so let's give them another round of applause. And with that, we will close out with our we wish you a Merry Christmas. Amen. There are refreshments upstairs. Thank you, Sister Avis. Oh, okay. She wanted me to put web on the end. Are you ready? You're rushing it, I guess. Thank you. The master has to touch it. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. Let's stand. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. Great tidings that he bring to you and your friends. Dear Johnny, Christmas and a Happy New Year. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish Merry Christmas and a happy Thank you. Let us all look to the Lord and be dismissed. May the Lord watch between me and thee. When we're absent, one from the other, together can we all say, amen.
Yeah, they were. I think that's good. Okay.